guy named Chris. And in this video, we're going to utilize ChatGPT within Power BI and return an analysis of data. Now, I know this is something that ChatGPT already does, or Power BI already does, through the natural language. You can do AI through cognitive services and even the analysis. But I wanted to see if ChatGPT can take a value from Power BI and return it. So we're going to show you how to do that right now. What we're going to do is start off opening Power BI. For this example, I want it really simple. I'm going to go real simple. We're going to start blank. And we're actually just going to enter some data. So let's call this category. Put in a bike. Brain and a computer. These have nothing matter. Bikes, bot walls, drains, and 20 computers. Not sure how any of these things correlate, but it seems like a fun thing. Let's make a bike. So, real quick, we can load in a table. And just for fun, we're going to add this to just a nice little grid. It's not going to mean much, but it just gives us the visual, so it returns a value. So from here, what we're going to do, and there's a lot of articles out there. So I followed a couple that are integrating ChatGPT into Power Platform, Power Automate. But what we're going to do is come out, and we're going to insert, and that's what we're going to end up using, Power Automate, to really get us the results. Now, I'll show you how we still need to return the data into something, so we'll do that in a second. But what we can start by adding is, we add these three values. Again, it could be anything in your data set. We're then going to come in here and create a new Power Automate. Now, when you start looking at the available Power Automates, nothing really matched. So what we're going to do, do instant cloud flow. So we're going to click a button. You can automate this a little more. But right now, there's no additional steps. We're going to go to it's a premium connector. And we're going to have methods. Now, where are these methods going to come from? This is where those other videos come. A great one from Giuliano De Luca was online, but we're going to step through as well. Hopefully ChatGPT is available. Okay, that just showing that that's good. But we're also going to go openai.com API. Now we're going to have to log in here, not a big deal. Once we are logged in, documentation, and we're going to go to API. Now, to get our API key, we can go to personal, view API key, and you can see I've already created an API key, so I'm not going to create that again. But, and I'm looking into the side because I have a copy for it for later. But what this value does, there we go, save that. What in here, the important aspect is if we go back to documentation, making requests, this is where we can get our information. So what we're gonna want is the completions. And we're going to do a post. Now, we've got two headers according to the documentation. Content type. authorization. And this is where we are going to enter the API key, which is the key that we have. And then in the body down here, you've got different options to return, or to get with the body. What I did for mine is I came down and I pulled it out of this completion here. So it's this body right here. Now, there are limitations, and this is where the maximum tokens run into this by testing this on other data sets. The request and the completion can only be 4,096. So you have to make sure that you're not sending in too much data because it needs to return at least, sending too much data is going to hit 4,000. But also that's it's a combination of the return and the request. So what we're going to do is post. Now, X7, I'm going to go 1,500 for this. And we're going to say this is a test, but we're going to change this and say, what is Power BI? At this point, we're going to hit save. Now, so far, this is what's going to post and it's going to return. But how do we get that data into Power BI? So, when I was first doing this, I went to Power BI and I'm like, oh, we can return it into a value, a field. We really can't. I'm sure there's maybe other ways to do this. Exporting, okay, refresh your data set. But what I liked about this was we can do add rows to a data set. Now, as you will learn, this data sets, if I come out here to demo, I've got a ChatGPT data. Now I have a lot of other data sets inside of Opal Demo, but these data sets are the real-time data sets. So what we're going to do is go out to Power BI, and we're going to come down to a streaming data set. We're going to select the API. This is going to be a ChatGPT. What we're going to do is just call it reply. That's going to be the only value that we're going to have. Now, do I recommend having a timestamp? Yeah, something like that that you know. But we're going to have a reply. The other thing I was looked at was the historical data. I did end up turning this on because it kept wiping out some of the data. Again, this is a demo for everyone to just play with. I think some of the things I'll show you, recommendations on one, you can improve on this. But for now, just to see how it works, we're going to hit reply, create. So all it is that for now. We have the push up here. We don't need it at this point. We got a new ChatGPT reply. So we're going to go back into our report. And always like to just save it in a new step. Add rows to a data set. Opal demo. I should see two of them. Yep. GPT. And the table is real-time data. From our HTTP reply, we have a status code. What we really want is inside the status code, we've got text. And so what we're going to do is do JSON parse. At this point, we're going to take the body of the return, and then we're going to get the schema. Where's the scheme? Schema. What's nice is we can get it directly from the documentation. We know with Power Automate, we can generate from a sample. Now, And we go into the data set here, we have different fields, and we're going to select text. At this point, we can save. And I would save and apply them. And now you can see, since we applied the button to number two. Up here, what I'm going to do is call it, what'd you say? We're going to go back to the report. Now, this allows it to run flow. But where are we entering the data? Or where are we seeing the data? So in here, what we're going to do is come out here to the Power BI datasets. Now, before I click this button, I want to show you where I had to set this. During the testing, I did have to come into the options. And it actually told me to do this. And I had to enable direct query for PBI data sets and AS. This is just FYI, you have to set that. Restart Power BI Desktop. But doing that allowed me to connect to different. If you notice, I keep spelling ChatGPT wrong, but good. Connect. Here I might get the real-time data. Of course, I trust it. And now I've got a single field. I'm going to call reply. Now, I'm going to keep it as a table of sort so we can see. But at this point, we can hit save. And save. Come up here, triggering the flow. Now, I don't know about you, as I trigger flows, I always go like the kill lean. Make sure my flows are working, and you will be able to see the flow within Make That Power Automate, but all of the features are not present. Just be aware. Okay, 9 seconds, looks like it succeeded. I'll come back into here and I refresh the data. There we go. So we're getting responses. This is perfect. So now this is where I think we can come in and make improvement. So if I edit the flow, open up the chat, the automate that I want. This is where we can actually include the data from that grid. So what if I asked, please, I don't know why, I always say please. Please. And data and please, actually keep it right there. And down here, I can actually put Power BI data. The data that I sent in, the whole data, not just the sum, the item. You can even do an item, but I'm doing this for the whole data set. Now, initially, and this is a JSON thing, initially I tried to do an and add it. Didn't really work, so I just included right into the string. Let's say apply, go back to the report. Here again. There we go. The data looks normal. The cost is new. There's nothing odd that's out of the ordinary. So what if we went in? Again, this is just a test. So I think one of the things I would like to do is, it's been a while since I've edited this. It's an edit theory. But, well, I wonder if it will determine that the wall cost is $5 million. And that it's very high. Like, you could test on the fly. Trigger. It looks normal to the non category is doing this. So, again, not perfect. I think I have it selected, actually. That's probably why. But again, so what's nice about it is it pulls over the slice data. So if you have a lot of data, you can actually narrow it down to certain aspects. Okay, the data still looks normal. Oh, actually, right here, it looks normal. However, the cost of the wall is quite high compared to other categories. So it did analyze the data even further. So that's great. One of the things I'm thinking of adding here is a selection of pre-qualified statements. Please tell me what's the highest value. Please tell me what's the lowest value. Please give me, again, Power BI already does a lot of this, but I wanted to see if ChatGPT could do it. And as you can see, it definitely can. I went back and I actually asked if ChatGPT can analyze data, and it can identify patterns and generate the insights. So what I ended up changing in my flow to see if I can get additional data and insights is in the HTTP, I've changed it to say, please identify patterns and generate insights for the following data. I will admit this made a big difference. It provided a lot more information. I tested this on a service board and it actually gave me 1 through 5, the analysis of the data itself. I recommend trying it out. Hopefully it gives you as much insights as it was giving me. This is some guy named Chris. Have a great day.